Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today we're talking about the Cartesian coordinate system again, and we're going to be plotting points. And when we plot a point on the Cartesian coordinate system, we are talking about an ordered pair. So I've got a list of ordered pairs for us to plot. Remember, the horizontal is the x-axis, and the vertical is the y-axis. And when you plot an ordered pair, you work alphabetically. In other words, x first and then y. I'm going to number a few of these things, and I want to remind you that they're on the line, not in the space in between. So this has to be negative 1 on this line, that kind of thing. And when you're plotting points on the computer, they already have the points written in there. But if you're trying to do an assignment and you don't number these, sometimes it's easy to get off and you're having to count them every time. So my suggestion is take the time to put numbers on there. So now I've numbered my coordinate system, and I know the x and the y axis, and I know that the first number in my ordered pair represents the x, and the second represents the y. So we always start at the origin. For this first point, I'm going to say I have x is 3, so from the origin, that's that 0, 0 point, I go over 3, and I go up 4. And that's my point. I'm going to call this point 1, just because it fits on there better. But as an ordered pair, I would write it 3, 4. Okay. Number 2, negative 1, 2. From here, I'm going to go backwards 1 and up 2. And so I go back 1 because it was a negative. So this is my x value, and on the x-axis, negative 1 is left, and then positive 2 on the y is up. So then I have the point negative 1, 2. Okay. Number 3, 2, negative 5. Remember, we have quadrants, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So at the end of this, we're going to talk about how do we know which quadrant a point is in? All right, so 2, negative 5. So we're going to go 2 over because it's positive 2, and then what? It's negative 5, so we're going to go down 5, and we would end up right here. That's our point 3. Well, look at number 4. It's got a 0 in it, and those are going to be very special and important to us later. So anything that's got a 0 in it is always kind of a cool case. So for number 4, we're starting at the origin, and what the x is telling us to do is not to go left or right, but stay right there. So if it's a 0, we have 0 movement horizontally. And then it's 3, 1, 2, 3, and here is the point. That's going to be landing exactly on the y-axis. So I don't have a point over here yet. It's all the way down here. That's going to land there. But let me just talk about the quadrants for a second, because this is a nice time to talk about it. If your point is in the first quadrant, the only way that's going to happen is if you have a positive x and a positive y, because you want to go to the right and up. So the first quadrant is all about positive, positive points, which is how the number 1 landed in there, because I had a positive 3 and a positive 4. The second quadrant, in order to get to the second quadrant, you have to go to the left, but up. So you have to have a negative x, but a positive y. And so that's all about the negative, positive points. That's how 2 landed in there, because I had a negative followed by a positive. The third point I have was 2, negative 5. And so I had to go to the right because it was positive 2, but down because it was negative 5. And that landed me in quadrant 4, which means that a positive, negative point is the only way I'm going to get into that quadrant, because I have to go to the right and then I have to go down to get to that quadrant. So what kind of point would put us over here? Well, we want to go to the left, which is negative, but we also want to go down, which is negative. So we actually need, I hope you said it, negative, negative. Okay, so our next point, though, 4 was 0, 3. 0, 3 is not in quadrant 1. It's not in quadrant 2. It's not in a quadrant. It's on the axis. So there's six things that can happen. Your point could be in 1, 2, 3, or 4th quadrants, or it could be on the y-axis, or it could be on the x-axis. If it's on an axis, it's not in a quadrant. All right, number 5, 1/2 negative 2. So the reason I put this one in is because sometimes we get the impression that we're never going to have to graph fractions. I don't know exactly where 1/2 is, but I know it's between 1 and, I mean, I know it's exactly halfway between 0 and 1, but can I find that exactly on my paper? No. But it's going to be close. So I'm going to go over to half, and then I'm going to go down to negative 2, because the point was 1/2 negative 2. And so there's my fifth point. I shouldn't be surprised that it's in that fourth quadrant because I had a positive 1/2 and a negative 2. And a positive negative puts me in that quadrant. Negative 6, 0 from the origin. I'm going back 6 because it's negative. And then I'm not going up or down because 0 for a y. So that lands me not in any quadrant, but where? On the x-axis. Notice something important, and we'll talk about it repeatedly. If I'm going to be on an axis, I'm going to have a 0 in that point. Those are the red flag. When you see a 0, it's like, oh, not in a quadrant. It's not going to be in a quadrant. It's going to be on an axis. And it's going to be, if the x is 0, it's on the y. And if the y is 0, it's on the x. Okay, what if you get something like 11/2, 6, and you're like, what's 11/2? You can change that to a mixed number, or you can change it to a decimal, if that helps you plot it or helps you understand what it is in your mind. So 11/2 is actually 5.5. So if I was going to, and it's positive, and 6 is positive, that puts me up in the first quadrant. So I'm going to go to 5.5, and then I'm going to go up to 6. 5.5. Up to 6 right here. This was 6, and that's point number 7. I'm just not putting the ordered pairs because it gets a little cluttered to look at it that way. So what did I do? I changed this into a decimal or a fraction and then plotted it because I could visualize that better. I can also plot decimals. I don't know exactly negative 4.7, but I know about the range. This is the only point that's going to fall into the third quadrant because it's a negative negative. I'm going to go back and I'm going to go down. I'm starting at the origin as always, and I'm going back to 4.7. So it's closer to negative 5 than negative 4, and then I'm going to go down to negative 4. So this isn't exact science here. I'm putting a point pretty close to where I think it is. And if we had microscopes and measuring tools, we could get to that exact point, but this is pretty close. So that's plotting points, ordered pairs on a Cartesian coordinate system. Have a great day.